Well, Nottingham has two big strengths in research that might not seem very allied at first. We're very well known for our molecular microbiology, and we're also very well known for our early medieval histories, Anglo-Saxon and Viking history. And our rather unusual research project has brought these two strands together to look at early medieval anti-infection remedies.
At the moment, there is a big danger that we are losing the ability to fight infection with antibiotics. And of course, I come from a period where there were no antibiotics. I'm an Anglo-Saxonist and I work with Vikings. We chose this recipe in Bold's Leechbook because it contains ingredients such as garlic that are currently investigated by other researchers on their potential antibiotic effectiveness. And so we looked at a recipe that was fairly straightforward. It's also a recipe where we are told it is the best of leechdoms. How can you not test that? So we were curious.
So Christina worked to translate the recipe, and there were several things we really needed to think carefully about. So there were a couple of words, for instance, that were ambiguous, and we had to think about what ingredient was meant by those words.
Work eierschelf with henna. Ginnim kropliage, that is a type of allium, and garliage, which is modern English garlic, beria eimfiller, both of the same amount. You knoo the world to summer, pound them well together.
We reconstructed the recipe as faithfully as we could, and this, Bold gives very precise instructions for the ratios of different ingredients and for the way they should be combined and stored before use. So we tried to follow that as closely as we could.
There are certain things that they say in the recipe that you can use. For example, like the recipe was left to stand for 9 days and used to strain it through a cloth to actually, I guess, to remove all the particulates in it. But things like it has a part of the recipe is ox gall from a cow's stomach. So although we don't know for definite, we've tried our very best to replicate as we could. And the wine that's contained in the recipe, Freya managed to source from a vineyard that we know used to be there from the 9th century. So we've tried our very best to try and replicate it as well as we can.
We then tested the recipe by growing established biofilms, so sticky multicellular blobs of Staphylococcus aureus, in a synthetic model that mimics soft tissue infection. And we simply grew these bacteria, added the recipe to them like a topical ointment, left it for 24 hours, and then just recovered the cells and counted how many bacteria were still alive. And what we found was very interesting. We found that Bold's eye salve is incredibly potent as an anti-staphylococcal antibiotic in this context. We were going from a mature, established population of a few billion cells, all stuck together in this highly protected biofilm coat, to really just a few thousand cells left alive. So this is a massive, massive killing ability.
Biofilms are highly resistant to antibiotics. So this is one of the problems that we deal with on a daily basis in hospitals, is bugs form biofilm infections. So we figured that although our medicine killed Staphylococcus in a test tube, we weren't very hopeful it would work in biofilms. And yet again, we found that it really worked and killed all the cells in a biofilm. And then we asked a collaborator of ours in the States to, if they would test this in an in vivo wound model. And basically, the big surprise was that it seems to be more effective than conventional antibiotic treatment.
So how it works is still an open question, and this is something we're now moving on to look at. And we've got a couple of different ideas. It might be that there are several active compounds in the full mixture, and that what the full medicine does is it attacks the bacterial cells on several different fronts at once and makes it very hard for them to resist the attack. So they could resist one form of damage on its own, but not three together. It's also possible that when you combine these ingredients and leave them to steep, and the recipe uses alcohol, which is a solvent that can extract molecules and concentrate them, and it has to be left to stand for several days, according to the recipe. So it's possible that there's some chemical reactions going on in that mixture as it's left to stand. We might actually be taking precursor molecules from the ingredients and creating a novel molecule that has this very potent effect. At the moment, we don't know. We would very much like to find out, and we're working very hard to do that.
It is absolutely phenomenal. For me in particular, this is very interesting. I have been interested in the rational Middle Ages for a very long time. The Middle Ages are often seen as the Dark Ages. We use the term medieval these days, often used in the media, as pejorative. And I just wanted to do something that explains to me how people in the Middle Ages looked at science or some scientific experiments from a medieval context. So for me, this is a fantastic opportunity.
I still can't quite believe how well this 1,000-year-old antibiotic actually seems to be working. When we got the first results, we were just utterly dumbfounded. We did not see this coming at all. When we then made another batch of the medicine and tested that, had a couple of sleepless nights thinking, you know, what are the plates going to look like in the morning? And seeing that we could repeatably make this, we've made 4 independent batches using different, you know, fresh ingredients each time, and it has worked each time. Also, we've tested the medicine sort of again and again as it's been left just standing in bottles in the fridge being stored, and it retains that activity for a very long period of time. So I think that the obviously you can never say with utter certainty, because this works in the lab, it's going to work as an antibiotic. But the potential of this to take on to the next stage and say, yeah, really, does it work as an antibiotic, is just beyond my wildest dreams, to be honest.